As web developers, we use the console, the browser's built-in debugger, almost every day to fix issues in our code. But most of the time, we stick to just console.log. The thing is, the console has a bunch of other cool tricks that can make debugging way easier. Not many people know this, but you can even style console messages using CSS. It's a lot more powerful than we think. In this video, we'll explore some of those hidden gems. Welcome to Optimistic Web, where we explore the world of CSS and front-end development, one step at a time. Let's begin with the basics. You probably already know that the console.log method outputs a message to the console. It takes one or more arguments and processes them based on their types and formats to generate a message. So if we pass a string to console.log, we get a string output. As mentioned earlier, it can take multiple arguments and we can mix different types in a single call. Like in this example, the first argument is a string and the second one is a number. We can also check their types using the typeof operator, which tells us the type of each value. Next, we have the console.info method. It works just like console.log, but in some browsers, you might see special formatting. For example, in Firefox, it adds a small info icon before the message. Then there's console.warn, which is used to display warning messages. These often come with specific formatting, and when I say specific formatting, I mean browsers may style these messages differently, but they usually come in yellow with a warning icon. The last of the most common use cases of console messages is the error message. This usually shows up in red with an error icon, making it easy to spot. If your console is filled with too many logs, warnings, or errors, you can use the console.clear method to wipe everything and start with a fresh canvas. And by the way, using shortcuts like Ctrl plus L or Command plus K to clear the console is even better. Now let's take it a step further and look at some lesser known console methods. The first one is console.group. This starts a new group of messages and indents subsequent outputs by an additional level until the group is closed. So for example, we can start a group using console.group, and any messages logged after that will be part of this group. Then to exit the group, we just call console.groupend. You can even create nested groups if needed. Like in this updated example, the outer group logs two messages, then a nested group begins with its own message, and finally, we return to the outer group for the last message. To make things a bit clearer, the group opening statement can take an optional label. This lets us replace the default label with a custom one. So in our example, the outer group is labeled as level 1 and the inner group as level 2. By default, these groups appear expanded, but we can use console.groupCollapsed instead of console.group to keep things tidy. Now the inner group will stay collapsed unless you click the arrow to reveal its details. Now let's say we have an array with multiple items and want to explore it while debugging. Most of the time, we just use console.log to print the array as an object. That's totally fine and gets the job done. But when we use the console.table method, we get a neatly organized table with columns for the index and the actual values. This tabular format makes it much easier to quickly scan and understand the data, especially when dealing with lots of items or more complex structures like arrays of objects. It presents the information in a clean, readable way, helping us spot what we're looking for faster than digging through a long list of unstructured logs. Moving on, console statements can also make use of string substitutions. It works a lot like the placeholders we use in other programming languages, where special tokens are replaced with actual values from variables or data sources. For example, if we're trying to welcome someone, instead of concatenating multiple strings like welcome plus user plus exclamation sign, we can use the %s format specifier, which gets replaced by the corresponding argument value. In this case, %s is replaced by the value from the user variable. This keeps our logs cleaner and makes it easier to include dynamic content without string concatenation. There are multiple format specifiers you can use in the console. %s is for strings, %i or %d is for integers, and %f is for floating point numbers. In this example, The first specifier is replaced with the employee name, the second with the age, and the third is used for the weight. Basically, each placeholder matches up with the corresponding argument value in the list of arguments. Then comes a hidden gem of the console API. We're not limited to just printing messages. We can also apply CSS styles to them. All we need to do is add %c before the part of the string we want to style, and then pass the CSS rules as an argument. Any text before the specifier stays unstyled, while the text after %c gets styled using the provided CSS. Since we used %c at the beginning of the string, the CSS is applied to the entire message. But you can also style just part of the string or use the specifier multiple times in a single statement. So if you want to apply different styles within a single message, you can pass multiple sets of CSS rules. The first set will be applied from the first %c, the second set from the next %c, and so on. Before we wrap up, let me share a nice little tip. You might have noticed that these text colors look great in dark mode, but as soon as I switch to the light theme, something like yellow on a white background becomes hard to read. To make your console styles work in both light and dark modes, you can use the light-dark CSS function to define different colors for each scheme. But just keep in mind, not all CSS properties are supported in the console, and different browsers might handle styles differently. So it's always a good idea to test your output in multiple browsers to find a set of styles that works best. If you'd like to dig deeper and try out a few more console methods like console.assert, console.count, console.time, and others, I will add the link to the MDN page. Feel free to check it out and start experimenting. And if you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.